Hey, and welcome to the new tutorial of DSLR Boots. When you first open DSLR Boot, you are going to see this window. This is the window where you see all your events. Or you can make some new events here, duplicate some events, and you will see them all in this window. In this window, you can also see the start screen on the right, and you can see everything you have activated. Like this case, it's the photo is activated, and the GIF boomerang and video is not activated. We don't have effects applied or no green screen. Nothing is on, and you will only see that we have the print button is displaced in this event, and that's it. Email is also activated, and you can also see the message that is in your email settings. The message here is your photo, and the subject is here is your photo. You can all change this easily in DSLR Boot. So we're going to open this test event that is activated already by clicking on Launch Event. So when you have clicked Launch Event, the event is just opening. We get this message because we don't have a camera connected for this demo. So we can see here the test event start page. Well, it's a little bit of a mess, but we're going to fix that, and I'm going to show you how to do that. To exit this page, you can click right on this button. So this is the setting page. You can create a new test event. You're going to call it Test 2. Let's customize the settings. Now the screen editor should open up. In this case, when you go to settings, you can see the boot icons. You can turn them on or off. You can turn the labels on so no text is displayed. Do you want to see the live view? You can turn that off. We don't want to see a live view. When live view is on and you have live template preview on, you can see your pictures that are taken in your template. So if you turn it off, you can see only the preview of your camera. But in any case, you have a nice or cool template, you can show this in your start screen if you want. Then you have the browse button. Usually I turn this off because otherwise you have here in your corner always a picture to go back to your sessions. You can stretch your live view to fit your screen. You can fit it or you can stretch it to fill the screen. Choose template. You can allow guests to choose between templates that you have marked as favorited ones in the print layout screen. If you have more templates, you can choose your templates here. We're going to show you later. You have to activate the star with your templates. The more stars, the more templates you want to going to see. If you have an animated start screen, you can put it here. You can put here a start screen video. This is an MP4 video, and you can put it there. This is your unlock button. You can make it more transparent, or you can put it 100% to see it very good. But you don't want mostly of the time that people can see the button because they're going to push it. So I turn this most of the time completely to zero. So then it's a secret button. The touchscreen is activated, or you can work with your keyboard if you want. Most of the time you want your touchscreen to activate. If you want a QR code, you can activate it here. So people can activate the boot with their cell phones. Turn this off for now. In the design window, you can change a lot of things, like here, all the buttons. I want the yellow color, or any color you want for the buttons, you can choose it here. So that's and choose the primary colors, everything you want, the color of the background. If you want to change it, you can do that here. When you have a mouse or a keyboard, it's easy to align all your buttons. When you have only the touch screen, it's a little bit harder to do. And here are your layers. Very easy. We have the live view, the browse button, and the guest QR, but these are deactivated, so you can see them here. If you want to add some text, you can do that here and you can put anything you want. Test text. You can also add an image or a complete made image file here. Let's say you made your start screen in Photoshop, you add it as an image. So let's say this is my start screen. If you want, then you can easily do that. Put this on the top layer, and I want the text above it. Well, you put the text layer above the other layer, and you can easily make it bigger. You can add some basic shapes if you want, and align everything. Or you can design this is Canva or Photoshop and put it here as a complete ready-to-use start screen. Then there is the capture screen. You can also move or change the icons here. Show a live view, turn it off. Crop the live view if you want or not. Mirror the live view if you want. You can rotate. If you have a camera rotated, you can change the rotation here. The camera will trigger automatically or not. You want most of the time that the camera is going to trigger when the countdown is zero. You can use a white flash screen after the countdown, so your camera has a little bit more time to focus when it's on autofocus, or you can turn it off. You can activate the cancel button here, or you can turn it off. You can change the color. And here you can, on the countdown settings, you can say, oh, I want them to at least have more than 5 seconds. So 10 seconds for the first picture, then 5 seconds for the second one. The preview time of the picture is 3 seconds. You can automatically, if you have more than one picture, make a GIF. I'm going to turn that off, and for the rest, the GIF is off, boomerang is off, and video is off. And this GIF is the same as this one, but without special layout that you can activate here. Or you can make a separate GIF with more pictures than the one you have for the photos, camera, settings, like I said. We don't have a camera enabled, and if you have all your input, you can activate it here. The sharing screen. You also can change everything you want, the duration, the done button on or off. Or you can completely skip the sharing screen. You want to show the original photos that are taken without the templates. You can turn this off so guests can search for an older picture if they want. You can set retake on so they can start over without printing or sharing. So when after 30 seconds, everything's going back to start, if you want that here, you can activate the QR code on the screen, the print button, email, or no email. If you want, let's say, email. You also can change where the buttons are. So you can put it here if you want, make it a little bit bigger so you can all change these settings if you want. If you don't want it, you can just go back while I'm in the design window. You go like, we set it to default if you don't want to change it, and you put it where you want to put it. I want it here back. You can change the font, the colors. Everything is a little bit the same as before. The print layout screen. Here you can make your layout for your pictures that are printed, your photos that are printed. In my case, I have it on 2x6 and make it double when you print. If you activate this, it will print double. You can also use a 6x4 layout. I'm doing this now fast, just for the tutorial. So you can adjust these till they are perfect and your printer will cut it in half. You have also all your layers. If you want to add your design in the background, you click on image, you look for a design. This is a PNG transparent. So it is on top of all the pictures, on top of all my photos. So I will lock this. When you lock it, you can easily adjust everything. Now this layer is locked. You see this with this lock. So now you can't move it. Now I can just take my pictures, put them behind the layer so it's easier to fill everything. Voila. Make it a little bigger. And of course, you can save this setting if you want. I'm going to do it now fast. When you do it this way, you lose a little bit around the picture, but you can easily adjust this. And if you want, you can make it smaller. It's fitting better. Thank you for watching and follow part 2.